we cry out loud. Father, just forgive us. Hear us when we say, we'll give you, give you, give you everything, our lives and souls today.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. God bless you, God bless you. We are here once again on the Midweek Praise, but tonight we are on the newest, hottest talk show on Wednesday night. Amen. We starting it up. We getting it geared up. We ready to go. We roaring like a lion. Amen. Tonight, Men to Men Talk Back, the talk up. Amen. You let somebody know that the talk up is every Wednesday night on Midweek Praise. That's right, where we have our guests each and every week will be Pastor Carl Young, amen. And also we will have other guest pastors and prophets and evangelists and apostles and bishops on. Every time we do a little something extra, we'll have them on this broadcast. But again, we thank and praise God for you tonight for listening to this hot fire, this new, amen, Men's Talk Up, amen. The Talk Up is here. Men to Men Talk Back. We get to talk back to one another. So I'm going to be bringing on our guest, amen, Pastor Carl, in just a little bit. So continue to listen in and share this on your broadcast, and we'll be right back. Amen, everybody. What's happening, y'all? What's happening, brothers and sisters? Listen, the newest, hottest talk show, amen, on Wednesday night, Midweek Praise, is now in session. We now in effect, baby. We're so excited about this new thing that we're doing, Men to Men Talk Back. Amen. It's time for us to talk back to each other. It's time for us to talk and tell somebody that, hey, holiness is right. Amen. We need to start talking about these things. We seeing, we are addressing them. And again, we are not by far judging, but we're going to talk about some issues because, you know, we got a standard, brothers and sisters. As men, we got a standard. So Men to Men Talk Back tonight, the talk up. So you let somebody know that every Wednesday night, we're going to be here at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Our guest every week will be Pastor Carl Young. Amen. God bless you, Pastor Carl. What's happening, my brother?
Amen. Amen, sir. Just excited. Another Wednesday, amen, that the Lord has allowed us to see here tonight. Amen. We are on assignment now on Wednesday. Amen. So, like Pastor said, everybody tune in. Amen. Give you some of the hottest topics going around the church arena. Amen. We're going to be addressing them. Amen. And we just excited about what God is doing. Amen.
Amen, man. I'm telling you right now, I'm glad to have you on, brother. Hey, have you had dinner tonight?
Not yet, but the wife, she got some pork chops brewing, so I'm ready.
Hey, look, my wife came home and cooked the meal. I sat down. I think I had a plate of bones.
Oh,
I had a plate of bones, man. She cooked some, she did some wings and stuff and some sides, man. And I tell you, it's always good to come home and the pot is hot. Hey, I tell you what. Hey, you know, we're gonna have some fun on this show, guys. You know, we're gonna be talking. It's times we're gonna have some serious conversations, but you know, tonight we're gonna be just talking about some of the things that social media has been talking about. I mean, it's been some crazy stuff out here. Also, there's things that be going on in the news with America and how we trying to dictate other countries, and I mean, it's just so much, and we have to talk about it. You know, we got to talk about that as well as what the Word of God is saying to us. But I'm excited, man. I don't know about you, Pastor Carl, but I thank God first for you. And I'm excited about this new program, man, because you know it's only going to get better, bro.
Hey, man. The biggest thing, you know,
Pastor
Carl, is that God has ordained it.
Amen.
I mean, this wasn't something that Andy started out to do, that we planned. Amen. We just let God just lead. It just God brought this together. So that's why I'm real excited about it. My spirit, you know, I feel that this is just something that I really feel that God wants us to do. So I'm excited about that in general.
Amen. You know, that's right. You know, because everything has an appointed time and everything is destined. You know, when we wake up tomorrow, if the Lord allow us to see a new day, everything in this day is going to have its own purpose, and its time is already laid out what the day going to be. We just got to make it the best, and we're going to praise God for what he's done and what he's going to do in that day. But I thank God for this broadcast, and I thank God for now this season. Amen. He's bringing us together to do a work on this radio broadcast. Amen. But we welcome to the show, brothers and sisters, those that just tuned in. You already heard him, Pastor Carl Young, pastor of Tabernacle of Faith. Amen. Here in the city of Lewisburg. Amen. His wife, Pastor Tammy Young. Amen. And I thank God for them as well. But tonight, brothers and sisters, before we go, let us say a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come once again, humble God, thanking you for another day, Lord. We thank you for waking us up this morning. But God, we thank you for a right mind. We thank you for a tongue to be able to talk, God, a mouth to be able to open it, God, to proclaim, God, how good you are. But God, we just love you tonight. We praise your name tonight, God. We just want to encourage those that are listening, God, that regardless of what they're dealing with, that you have not finished with their situation yet, because every day, God, you continue to make us, oh God, grow into what we are dealing with, God, that we can get stronger. And we thank you, God, for giving us strength to endure through the pain, through the suffering, through the setbacks, and through the disappointments. Oh God, we thank you, God, for just giving us the strength to keep moving and keep pushing, oh God. But God, we thank you for this broadcast. We thank you for Pastor Young for accepting the invitation to come on every week, God, that we can talk about the different topics and things that are going on in the body of Christ, and as leaders, and God, and as men, God, that not only men that's in the community, but men of family standards, God. And we thank you, God, for being loving husbands, oh God. We thank you, God, for just being loving unto you, oh God. And we ask right now that you bless those that are tuned in tonight, God. Touch their homes, their situations, their sickness, their illness, God. Bless their finances, oh God. Bless them on the job, God. Increase their territories, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we just love you. We praise you, oh God. We ask right now that you be in the midst of these airways, oh God, that we talk about the conversation that will heal, that will make aware, God, that some things are going on in the atmosphere, God, and we got to be attentive to, God. And God, have your way on this line tonight, God. We thank you again for each and every person that's represented tonight. We thank you for those that will listen to the playback, God. Every week we want you to bless us and be in the midst of everything that we do. We thank you, God, for your son Jesus that died. But God, we thank you, God, that he now lives within the inside of us. We thank you, God, for giving us grace and mercy. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus for everything. We thank you, O Lord. Hallelujah. We bless your holy name. And God, this is my prayer unto you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen. Amen. You want to go first, or you want me to break it down tonight? Because I'm telling you, I'm blown away what I just came across these last 24 hours or so. Man, I'm telling you.
Hey,
Man, I don't know if you I don't know if you got a chance, cause I think I went back tonight. Who we gonna just discuss tonight? And now I ain't trying to tear nobody down, but we got to, man, we got to start holding people accountable. You know, we to become a weak nation of people that feel like nobody can say nothing. We don't want nobody to correct us. But tonight, man, I came across this brother, a prophet, Joshua Holmes, and this brother done said some foul, filthy. Oh my goodness. I mean, I can't even say on the radio. Did you get a chance to look at that video?
Yeah, I got a chance to look at it and research it and study it. And I mean, I told him, agree with you. Yeah, I mean, this brother has to be some accountability. People don't want accountability, you know?
Man, no.
Everything they want to do it in the flesh.
That's it, brothers and sisters, because, you know, I was sitting there, Pastor. I looked at this video because it just about blew up Facebook yesterday and Twitter and everything else. I mean, people, this guy gets on there and he gets to talking about a male body part and a female body part, but he ain't using the pronunciation that we should use in society, like vagina or penis. This guy went street hardcore. He went XXXX rated to the third power. He's supposed to be a man of God. Now, what if them children, amen, was looking in on this video, which he has followers? What about some of the followers that he has following him, has children, and they over there watching him, and he over there talking about sexual parts with no chaser? I mean, you know, he comes back today. I wish I could pull it back up. He came back today, Pastor, and try to fix what he said the other day. He tried to make what he said right by saying we all grown, talking about people let your children watch stuff on cartoons that are sexual, that are perverted. But that don't mean that you be just like the cartoon. Amen. Listen, let's look before you comment, Pastor, let me share this little bit right here. Listen to this right here. Hold on. Hold on right here.
Scandals, I done been through it, so that's why I had to be more mindful of what I put on my social media, because it can either go left or it could go right. You cannot bash people for commenting or having an opinion about a video that he put out in the open. He put that on social media. Now you give social media a voice to judge your life, to speak on what you say. If you don't want nobody to judge anything that you say as a leader, then you shouldn't put it out there. Mm. You have people that's following you. You have people that's sowing into your ministry. You have people that is looking up to you, and you have to watch what you say. Because the little clip that you say, you can have a whole, you know, sermon, and you could say one little thing that can make your sermon inaccurate. It could be the downfall of your sermon. It's sad, but it's the truth. This is the society that we're living in now. This is the time and the season that we're living in now. The church has to be held to a different account.
Stop right there. She said it perfect. The church has to be held to a different account, Pastor.
Amen.
You know, because this brother, go ahead.
Because here's the thing. When you don't have accountability, and you can get on the air, vulgar comment, and mix it with the word, and then what you ultimately do is you confuse people. Now, people who are not based in Christ, who are seasoned Christians, we can filter certain things. And I'm not saying that that makes you right, but I'm talking about the babe in Christ in the world. When you try to use the word for worldly stuff in vulgar language, that's not right. Wonder if Jesus did that.
Man.
Wonder if Jesus cussed and went off and did stuff like that. Jesus got his word across without cussing, without using with the world. See, this is the thing now.
Uh-huh.
We don't want to offend people. We want you to be like the world, because we feel like
That's it.
I withdraw all. We don't need no worldly stuff. We don't need no cussing. We don't need no twerking. We don't need no rap songs in the church with vulgar language in it.
Man.
That's it.
That's right. And he's tricking folks so easily now. Because, you know, Pastor, I'm going to tell you, I don't know if you watched the whole clip, but I watched it last night, and I did go back, and I went back about 3 or 4 minutes, because I said, I just got to hear this thing. If I heard it right, I'm going to tell you what. I listened to that thing, brother, and I want to tell you, man, this Joker got he has to have a nasty mind, because one, he done said that I'm not going to stick my thing in you, and your spirit ain't right. You know, I won't be one to be doing that. And man, Pastor, I'm trying to tell you right now. Now, look, you got people, man, was agreeing what he was saying. And man, then I was sitting there listening to, looking at some of the comments, and you know, while he was talking, I see a couple women said, "You have such beautiful eyes. God bless you." And that's, I mean, they just lusting. You know, they just sitting around, man. You should read some of them comments. But then there's some people that was really, you know, saying basically, if you know you're a man of God, stick with preaching the gospel instead of, you know, you going out being solely vulgar. And just like this sister said on the combat, you know, everybody's talking about it. And you know what? Guess what happens, Pastor? Like you said, we are not babes in Christ. But at the same time, that there are some people that's not even in Christ. And then how they, when they see this and hear this, how are they going to be drawn? You know, because they're going to feel like everybody the same, you know, especially when they don't have no foundation, you know. But I want to clear it up tonight. We're not like everybody else. but you know, we got to hold some accountability, and the whole thing we need to start doing is checking. We got to start checking. That's it. That's it. Nobody, you know, and you know what? Guess, and he's gonna attract like spirits. That's what he's attracting. Because if anybody that really loved God, I couldn't sit up there and sit up there and listen to this man talk about, and he's supposed to be a leader, man. I'm sorry, you know, I, you know, and you kind of justified by, you done said some vulgar. You done used the D and the P word. And I'm sitting around like, what? For real? And then today he made a new video saying, you know, I got a lot of people making complaints, a lot of people saying stuff. And talk, you know, a lot of times he sit there and he said, well, hey, you let your children watch this stuff on cartoon and they got sexual stuff and this and that. So now you putting your standard down to the cartoon, brother, basically. But the Bible says here in Ephesians 5:6, it says, let no man deceive you with vain words. Because of these things cometh what? The wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. And see, you know, he's got all of those vain words and you know, people are watching us. And see, that's another reason why people don't look to come to the church anymore. Like we supposed to be the hospital, but they won't want to come to the hospital because the hospital is no different than somebody coming to your house on a horse and buggy working on you. You know, the Bible said, go ahead, Pastor.
Go ahead, sir. No, go ahead.
Listen, this is what we got to talk about these things, brothers and sisters, because, you know, it ain't right. You know, we got to address it, you know. So the Bible says in Jeremiah 23:1, it says, woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pastor, God's pastor. It's woe unto us, amen, that scatter the sheep, to destroy and scatter the sheep. He destroying some lives, and now people are starting not to trust the men and women of God because of this one pastor. He probably got congregations that now they started to leave because he ain't talking right. And that's what make people not to want to come to the house of God, because they think, oh, well, he like this, so everybody else like that. You know, almost like pastor, almost like a relationship when a man do a woman so wrong and keep cheating on and he keep coming back and say, I'm gonna do right, and then he keep on doing the same old thing, and then after a while when she finally leave that joker, it's gonna be hard for the next one, because she gonna think that next one is gonna be just like what she came out of. Yes.
See, we've got to sound the alarm. We have to be aware.
That's it.
We have to be responsible for God's word.
That's it.
Amen. We have to warn individuals. And here's the thing, what it's really saying, if we have a responsibility, Pastor, to warn people about this stuff. Now, here's the thing. Do you think that me and you are just coming on here just making this stuff up? No. God will for this time. There are so much bad teaching in the land right now. There's so much compromising of God's word. But he told us that this was going to happen. Bad teaching, amen, and doctrines of devils.
Uh-huh.
These pastors get influenced by the devil. So it's like they're really saying something, but they're really not.
That's it.
That is not God. There should be a certain amount of conviction. If you really, oh my goodness, if you really got the Spirit of the Lord, and you preaching with the Spirit, teaching with the Spirit of the Lord in you, then you telling me that the Spirit of the Lord is telling you to say all the words.
Hey, that's it.
I got to call shenanigans.
Hey, I like that. That's it. That's it. That's it. Amen. Pastor, you right, man. You right on it, brother. Hey, I'm telling you, you hit it just on the head. I mean, you know, because Because I know that God delivered me from cussing. Amen. That's why I just can't stand it. It tense up my it flesh. It just crawls on me to hear vulgar and demeanful words, you know. And guess, yeah, like you said, if you can flow it off of your tongue that easily, then you might want to check yourself at the mirror and do a recount. Because, you know, ain't nowhere in the world. I wouldn't even do them words behind closed doors, now alone in public view, for real. Woo, my God. And like you said, they have no spirit of God, because the spirit of God won't allow us to say vain words. It just ain't. The two ain't matched up. And if you can flow it off your tongue and say it more than one time, and you ain't got no problem with it, come on now. What a God in that? And it knows it's going to offend somebody. Because, see, one, vulgar words don't need to offend people. You know, when you say, if you sitting in the room and just like, you know, I heard some women, let me give you an example. I heard some women at Walmart last year say they was in a barbershop somewhere, and the lady was saying that she will never go back there and take her kid there because the barbers sit in the barbershop and talked about a female's behind the entire time that she was there, like she was invisible. She felt so disgraced. And so therefore, you know, the same thing happening that, like what we're talking about today. You know, people hear this and that you done offended them. So if you offend them, where's the God in that? Because God ain't into offending us. He's into correcting us, and the word will correct us, but he ain't in that. He ain't gonna be inside of me and I'll offend you and your wife by what I say.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And you hit it on that too. Why do I call myself a man of God, spirit filled, but I am thinking that other are offended by what I'm saying. Because it says in Psalms 19 and 14, let the words of your mouth,
yes,
in the meditation of the heart be acceptable.
Yes, sir.
Of the Lord.
Yes.
Now listen, bro, we're going to break it down just like this. It says, let the things in your mouth be acceptable to the Lord. So when you stand before judgment day, when you say those words to God, those words that you said today, the P word,
my,
no,
that's it. That's
you
it.
Would not say that. Why would you say? Because you know it'd be wrong.
That's right.
But now you come down to this verse, be wrong, and be like, it's okay.
Right.
It's okay. All right. Have the spiritual maturity to say, no, this was wrong. I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's how I know these people do not have the spirit of the Lord.
Uh-huh. Because they're trying to make it right. Yep.
Stuff like that and not be convicted.
They, yep.
And then I see the video of him where I really knew that he didn't. And forgive me if I'm wrong, but I've been long enough. I've seen him praying for people. And this is what really gets me, where I know he had problems. He runs up to a person, and the person's standing in the heater line, and he acts like he hit him, and they fall back.
Hey, that's it.
Pastor, come on, Pastor.
Man.
I
have
never seen Jesus read about Jesus doing that.
Hey.
He didn't do all that. Yeah. People up, acting like you kicking people, and he was doing that. So I'm like, man, that is a show.
Hey, that's it.
The Holy Spirit and the anointing is not superpowers.
That's right. That's it, right. That's it. You hit it, Pastor. Let me tell you, you know, these pastors and some of these people, man, they ain't never more than the sorcerer. They the witches and the warlocks, they the sorcerer, they the magicians. You know, the Bible speaks to these magicians, and they tried to do the same thing Moses was doing, but they weren't powerful like Moses, because Moses had God. Amen. And these folk, man, when they could just take a coat, it's like, you know, take a coat and just wave it across and nine rows fall out. Ain't no way in the world. These folk Pastor, I clap. This is some comment. It need to be on comment view because it ain't no way in the world. You got 9 rows of folk. Joker just waving his coat, and everywhere he wave his coat, Joker just be falling all out on the floor and everything. I mean, it's a mockery of God. It's a mockery, and it's sad. You know, it's so sad. And like you said, yeah. You know, I'm gonna tell you something, man. I felt the anointing. I've had my eyes closed, in a service, and I felt the anointing so strong and so powerful that I felt the presence of the man of God, and he didn't even have to touch me. And I went out because you know what? That powerful anointing, man. Sometimes you don't even you be in the midst. You don't, man. You just that spirit of God will come down. You don't know if you'll fall out, you'll run. You don't know if you jump up or cry. But ain't no way in the world. I'm gonna take the I'm gonna take a hay maker and smack you in the forehead. He done knock people out. I done seen another video, Pastor, and I'm going to have to find it again and let you check it out. There's this pastor. Man, he picking folks up off the ground. He picked this woman up. He picked this man up. And people falling out, man. I said, ain't no way in the world. I said, oh, my God. This is... Man, look, he was walking around picking people up like he on WWF. But you know, and so look, people, you know, are confused. You know, that's why they scared. They say, well, hey, I ain't going to church. You know, they doing what the same thing. But see, everybody ain't doing the same thing. You know, so that's why we got to address this stuff, this stupid, silly mess. We got to address it because guess what? Everybody ain't doing this stuff. Everybody ain't going out here and talking nasty and saying perverted words, and we call ourselves a leader. There ain't no God in us. We don't represent God that way. You representing the world when you're talking that way. I'm sorry. Let's just call it like it is tonight. You represent the world. And you know what? You know what I'm saying? Because it's no way. Because I don't know. So what do his members do, Pastor? If they come up and they just have a conversation and start talking about the same body parts just say it to him, like, you know, how do they talk? I mean, you know, ain't no more. He done said it, so how do people go and respect him now? I mean, because he didn't. Like you said, he didn't have no accountability. David confessed to the Lord my infirmity. He said, you know what? I'm not going to put it on nobody else. I did it, God. I got the problem. You know, I'm not going to say it was Zachariah. It was me. I did it, Lord. It was me. It wasn't nobody else but myself. See, this Joker, instead of him coming back and saying, you know, I made a mistake. I should have not said the word. But no, he tried to justify it by talking about what the parent let the kids do.
Mm-hmm. I think that you made an awesome point when you said that the man of God didn't even have to touch you because you felt the anointing on him. That was the same thing with Paul. Paul was so anointed that he didn't have to do all that. See, the anointing don't work like that.
Mm.
The anointing does not work like that, people of God.
Mm. That's right. That's right.
You really cannot control the anointing. The anointing don't work like that. See, number one, it's the teaching. And most men of God, and you can see that he's fairly young. So what that tells me is he really didn't get no training.
Uh-huh.
See, the Bible talks about being taught.
Uh-huh.
Transgender, where he was transgendered to a woman, he came back and he got delivered from transgender. Now he's teaching all kind of stuff, all kind of out and stuff. Man, all kind of stuff like that. So my question to him was, I said, you just came out of transgender, where that was a serious spirit on you. Now, you didn't sit up under anybody, but now you're trying to teach somebody about the Bible. But you just came up out of transgender being the one, where you had operations and everything. You now, all of a sudden, a year later, you teaching people, telling people that, you know, really, there ain't no Jesus. Jesus is in us, and people are fighting. And the Lord put it in my spirit also, Pastor. It's just like when he gave them kings, when they said they needed a ruler. Amen. Mm-hmm. See, God will give individuals what they want.
Right.
All the individuals that fall in these pastors, that's doing all this crazy stuff, and prosperity passes, God is giving you what's in your heart.
That's it.
God is going to give you what's in your heart.
Yep.
So when you ask for a king, you want somebody to rule over you, you want somebody to stretch your itchy ears, that's exactly what God is going to do.
Uh-huh.
And there are plenty of pastors and stuff now that if you say, how do these people sit up under their pastors, you know what it is? It's entertainment.
That's it.
That's what really scratches your ears is.
Yep.
You can't entertain.
The new entertainment ain't God ain't in it at all, because you know what you said, you said it, Pastor. The anointing flows down and it flows abroad, man. It'll go through person to person when you all on one accord. Now you remember seeing that brother swing his jacket and about 9 rows just fell back. Man, that he's supposed to have been so powerful that the whole audience, I'm talking about all the way up to the nosebleed seat, should have been fell out. It won't end but the foolery. It's foolery. And you know, it's so many people. Yeah, they want certain things. They want prosperity, pastor. They want this and they want that. And I've even heard pastors, you know, or not pastor, but I've even heard deacons, you know, when they, especially in some of the traditional church, when they bring people in when they don't have a pastor, they try this one out and try that one out, and so they look at all of them, and one they really enjoy, but he might be long winded, and there's another one that come in that they kind of up in air with, but he brought a lot of people the next time he came out, and the offering was good. I heard people say, you know, we got to get him because we took up a good offering when he come into town. See, that's it ain't, man, Pastor, I'm trying to tell you right now, this ain't nothing I'm making up, but I'm telling you right now, these this is real stuff. People are gonna choose people because they can take up a big offering. It's crazy. Yes, sir.
Come forward. He didn't jump around. He didn't do this. He didn't go pick him up and put his hand up. He said, come forward.
Right.
He was there.
Uh-huh.
For days. Mm. He was there for days. And all Jesus said was a couple words, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you mean to tell me you got to run home to church and do all that? Because actually, dude, what you saying
uh-huh.
is when the Spirit of the Lord, the Holy Ghost is on you, and God's Spirit is on you, what you telling me is that you can control God's Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Think about that.
I know. Right. Man. Man, you know, I'm reminded, Pastor, at Pentecost when they was in one place on one accord, the Spirit of the Holy Ghost came down and they talked in tongues. Amen. It was like a roaring fire because they was on one accord. Amen. They was in a place. Amen. They was in a place together, and the Spirit of God went through all of them. I ain't talking about nobody went around fanning no coat, punching them in the face and knocking them out on the floor. The Spirit of God don't have to do that. Well, how foolery. We got to stop being fool people. And some of y'all might see this stuff. You're being fooled. And if you are in this type of foolery, it's my prayer that you get out and find you a Bible-based church that is going to be led by the Spirit of God and is teaching His word with none of that silly mess, because it's all silly mess. You know, I'm going to read this scripture real quick. The Bible says in Ezekiel, we're going back to Ezekiel 13:3. Thus says the Lord God, woe unto the foolish prophets. You see, foolish. And that's foolish prophets that follow their own spirit. See, these are the people that waving them coats around. Their own spirit. And have seen nothing. They ain't even seen the Holy Ghost. They ain't seen the Spirit of God in elevate in them, because they are their own spirit. They own self said, you know what? I can make this whole road just fall out. As a matter of fact, I hear some preachers back in the day say, you know what? I saved 1,000 people. No, you didn't. No, you did not. I can't say that I saved 100 folk. You know, I might baptize 100 folk, but God saved 100 folk, because if God didn't prick their heart that they need change, they would have never changed. Amen. So I don't think that we can do anything without God. But these folks here, this is what this prophet, and y'all saw him the other night. He had his shoes up, his bling bling. Oh man, he was just all in it, bro. He's just all in it. And everything I said, you are so handsome. Your eyes are so pretty. You see, how you talk is what you attract. And you attracting these women ain't looking at the word of God. They looking at this person. They looking at how this person look, this brother look. They looking at his eyes, his clothes, his shoes, his jewelry. Because now he let the door open up for Satan to come in. And now they don't believe nothing he say, but they're going to feel their appetite, their own appetite. This is what we got to do, remind ourselves. Woe unto the foolish prophets. You know, it says foolish. That means they doing stuff for their own self, their own glory. Huh?
I said, we were just talking about that.
Amen.
People have a glory.
Amen, you know.
They have a glory.
Yep, go ahead.
They got jewelry on. They got nice suits.
Mm-hmm.
Not so elegantly. They drive the Mercedes Benz and BMWs. Everything about them looks like prosperity.
Mm.
So what it does is, if you think somebody got Mercedes and Bentleys and all that, and nice suits and always dress nice and wear jewelry, you would look at them and think that they're blessed.
Uh-huh. That's it right there. Yep. That's right. He,
amen.
God gave him power.
Uh-huh.
You gonna do it.
You would do it.
Yep. Mm. Yep.
You would do it. And then this is how you know when you got a pastor that controls. It's when you
Uh-huh.
He don't want to talk to you. Mm-hmm. He don't want to come around. Or he'll tell somebody, yeah, you know, they being disobedient. Okay, I'm not disobedient. I've got $1,000 to give you.
Uh-huh.
Okay? I'm sorry if you think I ain't growing as fast as you need to grow.
Uh-huh. That's it. That's a lot of them. That's a lot of them today, Pastor. Yep. Mm. You talking good, Bo. You talking good. You talking great. You know what I'm saying? Because I tell you, this is what people see. They think people got it going on because of their status. You know, they looking like, so-and-so must be doing good, you know, because they got X, Y, Z, man. They always fit the part. Every time I see them, they clean, you know, and that draws, just like this brother here. He got 50,000 followers that watch that live because of how he dressed, how he talked. That's what he dresses. So they said, you know, I want a part of that. But you know what? I was talking to the Lord today. I was thinking to myself, all these people, all these preachers, all these rich pastors, there are so many rich pastors, but they in their same congregation, people can't even afford to pay their light bill. People can't even afford to get to work. People can't even afford to buy new clothes. But the pastor driving around with a Mercedes, the pastor driving around with a new BMW, he got a jet, he got a plane, he could go all over the country, and your members, I just can't understand that. You know, if God bless me, amen, with millions of dollars, then I want to be able to bless my congregation. I want my congregation riding. I want them dressed nice. You know, because we ought to be able to work together. If that's, you know, you ought to be like what your leader like, you know. But what happens is the leader get up there and he don't care about nobody else down there. He don't care about nobody else down there. And that's what you see. You know, because this is the thing. Now, you got a lot of multi-million-dollar pastors all across America. But you got people struggling, don't know how they gonna pay their bills. You know, if we true to God, then we ought to say, you know what? Every 2 to 3 months, whoever don't got a car, we gonna work to help Sister Susie this month. And 3-4 months later, we gonna raise some more money. We gonna help until everybody get a car. Good God, that's ministry right there. I'm talking about everybody. You know, if you need a place to stay, okay, this month we're gonna help you. A couple more months, we're gonna help you until everybody got a place to stay. Amen. If you don't have a job, then we're gonna work to get everybody a job. And after a while, everybody gonna have a job, a house to stay at, or apartment to live at, and everybody gonna have a car. Because guess what? You take a lot of offering up every week. I'm talking about $10,000 a month, and people can't even get to work. Because we are not dedicated enough to say, you know what? All right, this month, we're going to help Sister Barbara because she got a job and she got these kids. And then we want everybody to have a car. It might not be no new car, but it's going to be a dependable car. It's going to be one that we can all pay for, and we're going to help them. It's going to make us all happy. That's what ministry is. Come on, somebody. Woo, I'm feeling good right now. Amen. That's it. That's it.
They got to be in your heart.
Man, you talking.
Who you really are and what comes out of your mouth is predicated on what's in your heart.
That's right. That's
what's
right.
In your heart.
That's
not
right.
What goes in, but what comes out.
Uh-huh.
Heart, I don't care what you tell me about. As soon as I see how you are, I can tell what's in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not judging. I'm not judging you. I can tell what your character is.
Uh-huh.
What you found you. Mm-hmm. Okay? That's what your heart's gonna be, Pastor.
Uh-huh.
That's what, whatever you done, whatever you know to spend your money on, whatever you know to do, that's where your heart is.
Mm. That's it. You right. You right. Because you know, guess what? You know, after a while, I can't keep holding my guards up against you, because after a while I'm gonna get too relaxed, and I'm gonna really show you now myself. I've been holding up for a long time. I've been holding up for months. But after a while, now I done held up so long that I'm upset with something. Now I'm gonna show you me, and now you see me. You be like, wow, man, that was a curveball. I ain't see it coming. But now I see now. This was you the whole time. You was funny acting the whole time, but you had this persona that you was something else and you won't. My God, I guess this is the season now that us people, we still in the exposing season because we gonna be going to new season after a while. But people are starting to really show themselves. Hey man, I just ask God to let me be the same way. You know, I ain't got no agendas for nothing. I want to just love on folk. I want to see the people in the community grow up. I want to see things happen in people's lives. I want to see people busted and broke down. But going back into what we talking about, see, when we real, we can do little things to help. Now you might, I don't know what your finances are and you don't know what mine is. But whatever you can do on your level, it might not be on the same level, but I'm doing something too. See, that's you know, I might not give $100 to somebody, but I might can bless somebody with about eight haircuts, and you know, I might can do something like that, you know what I'm saying? Or I might can say, you know what, don't worry about it, that's on me, you know, I could do stuff like that. But see, it ain't about, it's about the heart, you know, it's about the heart. And what happens is people start to show themselves, like you said, it's easy for me to say something, but if I say something, then after a while, my action don't add up to what I'm saying, man. I'm just a joke. I'm a lie. You gonna look at me sideways, ain't you, Pastor?
Amen. Amen. But I'm gonna tell you, the one key thing when you know somebody is just who they really are. I've had people that I love, Pastor, that I looked up.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought with all this,
mm-hmm.
and they cut me off without even a whisper.
Mm. We on that
That's
same boat.
When you know somebody was trying to play.
Uh-huh.
They cut me off now. Cut me off.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
And when you see a person just change on you all of a sudden, that's how you know they're playing a facade.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
I've been the same way. This is who I am, and you've been who you are.
Yep.
So now, if all of a sudden, Pastor, I start acting different towards you or cut you off for just no apparent reason, and now all of a sudden, you like, man, what's going on, Pastor Carr? He like, man, he don't want to talk to me. He used to do this. Pastor, I was playing a role.
Right. Hey.
And here's the thing about it.
Uh-huh.
Don't care nothing about your feelings. Don't care nothing about all you did for them.
Uh-huh.
They don't think they was playing a role, and that's what's happening. These pastors and people in position, they are playing a role.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to attract you. Oh, my God. I heard chameleons. They are chameleons.
That's
they
it.
They play the part based on who you are.
They play the part good. Mm-hmm. That's it. You know, I've been in that same boat. You've been on one side of the seat. I was on the next side of the seat. We was in the same boat, you know. And you know, sometimes, like I said, that's that curveball that you really didn't expect. You thought you were going to get a straight line flyer, and they done curved it on you. And it came out the blue. You're like, wait a minute. Whoa, wait a minute. Where did this come from? I knew you scratching your head. Like, what did I do to this people? What did I do to them? You scratching your head. You be like, man, what in the world? And then you're thinking that you beat yourself up sometime. You know, I know I do, because you know what? My heart is the type of I'm the type of person that if I hurt somebody, I want to make it right. You know what I'm saying? I want to make it right. I'm not that person that want to hold a grudge. You know, because that ain't my makeup. You know, that ain't me. You know, if I done something, if I'm aware of it, I want to make it right. I'll say I'm sorry. You know, because I want to apologize. You know, if I did something. But sometimes, you know what, we had to stop kicking ourselves and say, you know what, it won't us. It won't us, man. We ain't with it. We ain't do nothing. And basically, we got to get to the point of saying, you know what. If they was like that, then they don't even deserve what you got. Because at the end of the day, go ahead.
Go ahead, Pastor.
No, go ahead, brother.
Here's the warning. When you know people like that, all
Right.
You know, where you been?
Right.
This is the warning that they want something from you.
Uh-huh. Oh, how... Hey, Pastor.
Because you ain't talking to me all the time. Now, all of a sudden, you come out of the clear blue sky like, hey, man, where you been? I've been trying to talk to you. I've been calling you and you put your phone off and I know you want.
Hey, I was about to, Pastor, I was about to say that. I was about to say that. Yeah. Hey, Pastor, I was about to say that. That's what they're going to say. Hey, yeah, I've been having a problem with my phone. I didn't get your call. I didn't get your voice message. I didn't get your text message, y'all. My phone was messing up, man. I'm sorry, man, you know, but I had you on my mind. That's it. Right.
I wasn't any value to you.
Right, that's it, right, yeah.
What's going on, too. It's a shame, though, too, Pastor.
Uh-huh.
There's a lot of people in the body of Christ.
Leaders.
They don't feel valuable.
How about leaders? These are leaders. That's it. You right on that. I'll tell you what. Going to another topic, Pastor, real quick. Talking about Jerusalem, and we want to talk about the United States for just a brief minute. You know, I was sitting there, and I don't really watch the news like that anymore, Pastor. But I'm gonna tell you, man. You know, all the talk and all the stuff that's going on, too, with that. You know, President, I'm going to just say Mr. Trump. I'm going to do him like he did President Obama. Mr. Trump, he recognized Jerusalem as Israel capital on Wednesday and announced plan to relocate the U.S. embassy there. And this is, this how, who gives the power and say, you now the new chief over there. Where do we get off as America to tell other countries how they gonna do? I don't get it, Pastor.
I'm gonna tell you why this happened. Like me being ex-military, a lot of other countries are dysfunctional. Mm-hmm. Now we're dysfunctional in ourself, America.
Right. Sitting here thinking like, okay, Israel's supposed to be a pretty decent sized country. I mean, they supposed to have resources. They don't have resources. I gotta look into what's going on in Israel. But even with that, on the spiritual side, Israel's supposed to be the people. They over there. I said Israel. They should be the people. They supposed to be self-efficient. They supposed to have the technology. They supposed to have stuff. They are much better than probably some of the other countries or the other places over there. But it has started a war. Don't you see they're starting to fight now?
Yeah, they're starting to fight because there isn't a disagreement. But the thing is that Jerusalem once was the capital of the Jewish people. If you look back at some history, Jerusalem was the capital of the Jewish people.
Mm-hmm.
But so many people like the Persians and the Romans and other people, they all came over there and tried to conquer it. They all came over there and conquered it. So it kind of got lost in the mix.
Right.
But I get different. Now, let me tell you what some people are saying and some prophets are saying, and we can kind of determine this. Some people are saying that President Trump really has done a lot for Christians. He initiated the Free Speech Act, which made it harder for us to marry people who are not of our faith or want same-sex marriage. So even what you see with the Baker thing now, that's getting a lot of where they're saying that you should make a case based on your belief. And Trump is one of the first presidents who said, hey, Jesus Christ, and he said, not happy holidays, Merry Christmas. So some people are saying God is using Trump's character to butt up against people who always trying to, because just face it, President Obama ushered in same-sex marriage, but same-sex marriage was a Trojan horse.
Mm-hmm.
See, because now they want consent to be 13 years old. Bestiality follows. Now they want to be able to legally marry animals. So it was a Trojan horse. But
I mean, you know, you're right. That's it. Go ahead.
You know, because if somebody came over here, we have a lot of backlash with the Muslims.
Uh-huh.
When they want to take prayer out of school, and they want to do this, we have a serious problem with that. So if you can just imagine the people over there in Israel, how they feel when somebody else from another country tell them what's right.
Right. That is a problem, Pastor. That is a problem, man. I mean, you know, because, you know, my thing is, America has been doing this. This ain't the first time we've done this stuff. There's not another country that tells us what to do like we tell other countries. That's real. I mean, you don't see you don't see England telling us what to do anymore. You don't see Russia, you don't see Japan, you don't see China, you don't see Africa, you know, you don't see Europe, you don't see these countries saying, America, do you need to do this? You know, we're the only one, we dictate everything across the world. But yeah, I do believe that everything has to play its role, and I think that President Trump, Mr. Trump, is set for this time, and he got many faces, so he gonna fool a lot of folk. He gonna fool a lot of folks. See, I mean, you know, now let me tell you something. Now, regardless of whether I vote Democrat or Republican, if I feel like he or she is an honest person, if I can feel something from them, you can be a Democrat or Republican. I'll go for you. But the thing of it is, I sit back and I watch this man, and I see him, he say one thing, and then he turn right around and say, I didn't say it. And I'm like, what? you really say that? Did you even say it?
He's not honorable.
Right, he's not honorable, but yeah, he's appointed for this time. Everybody that said we need a new president, we want one that look like us, we want one that has a rich status, and now look at what they got. They got their king.
Yep.
They got their king, Pastor.
Yep.
They got the king.
Mm-hmm. They got their king.
That's it. My brother was in desert. My brother was
so
in.
Throughout the world.
Right. Yeah. That's why. Look. Yeah. We got the big gun. We got the bully. We got the bully with all of the bombs and all of the guns. You know. And like my brother, he was in Desert Storm. He fought over there in that Desert Storm during that era of Desert Storm and the Gulf Wars over there. But like I said, yeah, we are the most, besides the Roman Empire, we the most warring country in the world. You know, Rome was like that. Rome was something fierce, boy. But they soon came down. It was many. I'm talking about like many years. I mean, too many years for us to even count up. But eventually, Rome failed. So America, it's going to show its might, but after a while, the enemy going to say, if he go to sleep and he can't push them buttons, we going to get him.
Yep.
So
here's the thing, too, we got to look at.
Uh-huh.
If the United States fails, so for the world economy.
Right.
So for the world economy.
Right.
Right. If something happens in the United States, it will be chaos in the world.
You're right, because you're right, because you know why? Because we help a lot of people, man. I mean, you know, even though we in this deficit, a lot of people count on us versus any other country. We always will go send aid. We'll go now. We'll send that aid over there. We might be getting something for it, but we're gonna send that aid over there. And America always be the one that go to the aid of the people with food and water. They ain't looking at nobody else, you know. Because sometimes I used to wonder, some years ago, I was like, every time you see a disaster in another country, heck of America coming to the rescue, they sending this and that. I'm like, dang, you know, we got people right here, you know. But you know what? The people do count on us. And like you said, if we go down, then that means that the World Trade, not the World Trade Center, but you know, the Wall Street and all them boys and everything going downhill. Uh-huh. Yeah.
You know the one thing, Pastor, that keeps America afloat is we got the most gold.
Right.
America, really, we drive the price of gold and the value of gold up.
Uh huh.
Diamonds. People act like diamond. Any man, there's so
Mm-hmm.
People, that's why when Valentine's Day came in, they started Valentine's Day to drive the value of diamonds up. Because they started to make like diamonds was just like, oh, you ain't got many diamonds. Now you look at all these diamonds. These rappers walking around with so many diamonds in their necklaces and all that. Because it's about a lot of diamonds. But we put value on diamonds. We put value on it. It's what, it's just like, you know, in the church, you pastor. It's what we value. If people value prosperity, that's what they get.
Right.
If people value the prophets hitting them with jackets, it's about what you value. And it all comes back to your basic thing, the gospel of Jesus Christ. As long as we continue, Pastor, to value the gospel, see, we value the gospel.
Right. Right.
We are not moved by the wind, Pastor. We stick it to the course, and that is the gospel of Jesus Christ, and that is, like you said tonight, being accountable for what comes out of the church.
That's right. You know, we got to continue to preach the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, and not only that, but, you know, we got to send a warning out, because there's some fakers out in the camp, and you know they taking over with all of this theatrics and everything, all of the fun church, you know, the churches, the hottest, the hippest, the you know, the roly churches, you know, but because the devil, like you said earlier, the devil gives stuff too. People, you know, God gave Satan power over to rule over this world. He took Jesus up on high and said, look, if you bow down to me, I give you all of the kingdoms that you can see. You mean to tell me he could tell Jesus, I'll give you this if you do this? So if he tell Jesus that, what you think he gonna tell to the common man, the regular brother? Who you think he gonna say? I'll give you wealth if you pervert the scripture, if you do your own thing and think it's about you. You have more than enough. And that's why, hey, that's why people don't flock to our ministry, because they don't want to hear this stuff. They don't want to hear discipline. They don't want to hear the okay. Because see, one thing about it, once discipline comes, then it's time for the next chapter. But see, it's so out of line, you know, just like the military, you know, it take more than one day to turn a cadet into a Marine or a soldier. It take time. It take discipline. If ain't no discipline, you'll leave from battle. You'll be so scared because you're going to say, you know what? I ain't getting shot for them. You go over there. I'm going to hide over here. Ain't no discipline. So therefore, we got to talk the way we talk. We got to preach the way we preach. But at the same time, whatever the Spirit gives us, that's what we're going to say. So if the Spirit gives us the toe-stepping message, then that's what it's going to be. But at the same time, we'll come back and give you what the Spirit say. We'll give you something to lift you up. We'll give you something to edify you. Amen. But you know, we so out of shape. Because see, what profits you that you just want to hear some edification service every Sunday, and then you go out and you can't fight against the devil. You can't go out and stay on the battlefield because you ain't got no discipline. And now you go out and somebody curse you, you curse them back. But you come to church every Sunday. That's why, because you ain't got nothing. And the leader ain't teaching nothing. They ain't preaching nothing, ain't teaching nothing, ain't talking about nothing. Because see, the old preachers used to talk about sin. They talked about hell. And they had church filled up to the brim. Couldn't get another person in the church. It wasn't a pew empty. But now we talk about it. You so scared to come to church. But see, them people really feared God. And you know, when they feared God, but at the same time, when they heard a strong message, you know, they'll come change in their life. Because when you was out there, when you left the pastor, when you left the church, when you weren't around the members, you were faced with something that said, you know what, you ought to go head on and slip. Ain't nobody going to see you going on out there and cheat. Go on out there and do your thing. And you ain't heard nothing. The preacher don't preach nothing. Guess what you're going to do? You're going to fall short. But if you got a preacher that's preaching something, you're going to go out there and be in that situation and be like, Pastor Carl, he preached on that Sunday. Lord, forgive me. Lord, help me. Give me strength. And then you go back the other way. You yielded it to the temptation because you heard the word of God. You heard a strong message. Amen? You heard it. So we got to stop. We got to stop watering down, Pastor. Amen. You know, these pastors out here, these preachers, these prophets and apostles and all that, you know, they got to stop watering down. And then too, we got to, the world is looking at us. You know, the world looking at us, and we ought to carry ourselves. We ought to talk to folk and still have a firmness and believe what you believe in. Don't be putting up no foolishness, you know, because there's some time you might come across some foolishness, and people going to check and see what you're going to say, being that you're a man of God or a woman of God. But guess what? I be stirring them brothers down there. You know, I be getting on them. I mean, you know, I would have slacked up a little bit, Pastor, but you know what? Them same ones that I had to straighten out came back and they apologized. They was in a condition. Their eyes were red. They were really wanting themselves. But they would actually come through there and apologize. And just the other day, we were all sitting out there laughing and joking. See, I that's one thing that we got to do. You know, you got to give a firmness, but at the same time, you got to go back. Then when people realize you, they're going to start respecting you more, because they say, okay, you know, he ain't just telling me this and acting like he better than me and can't speak to me. He is telling me this, but at the same time, he's showing me love.
That's it, Pastor.
Yep, that's it.
That's Oh,
God bless
you. That was awesome.
Hey, God bless you.
That is exactly what it is. See, you can't expect this to be a great Christian in one day, 2 days.
That's
like
it.
Say, it takes time and strength. Mm. You got to go through different phases.
That's it.
That was awesome,
Pastor. Hey, God bless you, man. Listen. Man, I'm so excited about this show, man. I could do it all night, man. I'm telling you, I'm having such a marvelous time. And one thing about this, Pastor, you being on here every week, man, with me, it's going to be a blessing. But I do want to let the listeners know, we will be bringing other people on as guests. But Pastor Carl will be our every Wednesday night guest as we have this new show, Men to Men Talk Back, The Talk Up. So y'all need to put on Facebook. The Talk Up is real. We have real conversation. We talking about real things that really happening today, and that make you aware that there are some false prophets, there are some false teachers, some false preachers. There are some people that say they dressed the part, they looked the part, they got this going on, but they using folks up. They seeing what they can get from you. So this is the stuff that we're talking about, and you need to come in here, bring a buddy next time, next week. You invite somebody else in. If it's 5 people, 20 people listening tonight, if it's 100 people listening, I encourage you to invite one person more next week. Amen. And so, again, we will have other people on as him and I talk. You know, depends on what the conversation is. We'll reach out to another pastor, brother, or apostle, or bishop, and bring them on the show, and all of us will be in conversation. But again, Pastor, you got anything else you want to say to the listeners before you skip up out of here?
Yeah, I'm just also so excited about what God is doing in this season. You know, I can just feel just the anointing. And like I said, Pastor, most of the time that you do stuff with people, it's because y'all are in agreement.
Right.
Looking to agree. Yep. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We can't walk together unless we're in agreement.
Yep.
So a lot of times, we probably was walking with people and doing stuff where people wasn't in agreement, mm-hmm. So it's hard.
Right.
This is easy for me.
Right.
Right now.
Amen.
The same thing you have is the same thing I feel.
Hey, that's how ministry. Amen. But I feel it too, Pastor. You know why? Because, like you said, we are in agreement. And when we don't have no agenda. See, I could say I don't have no agenda, but if my spirit on the inside got other motives, it don't work out. You know, it's just like, you know, this show, because we're in agreement, because we are here for each other. That's the whole thing. We are here for each other. We are here for the people that are listeners. We are here to bring life into other people's lives. And we ain't got no agenda. We ain't thinking about our own self. See, and so it's going to grow. I feel an explosion. I feel, boy, this thing is getting ready to turn up, boy. And after a while, y'all going to be able to look out for some shirts. Look out for some vans, because we're going to have the TMA Radio Show vans running around Franklin County, Raleigh. I'm going to call it now. We're going to have some vans. We're going to have some people working out in the community. We're going to have some people at this football game, the basketball games, doing it on the show. We're going to do some stuff this year, amen, because it's in the work. It's in the coming, and we thank God for what he's doing.
Amen, Pastor. I mean, you said it. It's our season.
Amen.
We've been through the trials. We've been through the disappointments. We showed ourselves worthy to God, that we handled the middle things. You know, we didn't do everything right. But through all our trials, all the doubters who said we would never do this, we would never do that, we still put God first. And I just think that God is honoring us in this season, because I just feel such an explosion in my spirit. You know what I'm saying? My spirit is excited, coming on the line. I feel purpose.
Yes.
See, some people do stuff and they don't feel that, you know, they called to do. See, I feel that we was called to do this, Pastor.
Yes.
I feel that.
Yes.
So that's what the excitement is, when you feel that you are operating in your purpose. But like you said, every Wednesday night, we got all kind of contacts with people that's going to be coming on this show, giving our opinion, man, just special guests, man. I mean, the people out there, listen, just stick with this. Y'all gonna learn, you're gonna feel the anointing. This is gonna be great for the body of Christ.
Amen. Pastor, I want to thank you for being on tonight, man. I can't wait the next Wednesday. I'm ready to speed dial next Wednesday up, because there's so much that we could talk about, man, I'm telling you. But I think that the people are going to be blessed. I feel like the people are going to be blessed. And not only that, they're going to get scripture. They're going to get, might even get comedy air once in a while. But that's what it's about. We're going to be doing a lot of amazing things. And with this broadcast, you watch how it grow. We're going to be able to impact some lives, especially some young people. And so, Pastor, thank you. God bless you, man.
Oh, God bless you too, Pastor. Have a blessed night.
Amen. You the same. God bless you. Amen.
In this race we call life, no guarantee. One day you're doing fine, the next you're on your knees,
praying that the day will come for your victory. Keep looking to the sky, God sees everything.
Smiling on you and me,
everything will be okay if you just believe.
Fight, we're gonna pray. Ha ha, yes, 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 y'all. We get ready to do it. I feel good tonight. We had a wonderful conversation, wonderful dialogue tonight. And we thank God for all of you listeners that tune in tonight. If you missed it, you can go back as soon as I finish broadcasting live. You can go back, listen to the whole thing, man. Don't skip over, just listen to the whole thing. in its entirety. We thank God for tonight's broadcast. We thank God for Pastor Carl for being on. And he's going to be on here every Wednesday with me. I got somebody going to be on here with me every week. Every week. Amen. Especially this is Midweek Praise. But Midweek Praise, we got tonight. Men to Men Talk Back. The Talk Up. Amen. The Talk Up. That's it right there. Hey, say, yeah, I was listening to the Talk Up. And they're going to say, what is that? Men to Men Talk Back. We talking to each other. We talking about things in the community. We talking about men. We talking about leaders. We talking about everything. Amen. We talking about not only spiritual leaders. Leaders are supposed to be spiritual leaders. But at the same time, we talking about America leaders. We talking about everything. We covering. We ain't going to leave nothing undone. Amen. So, again, we thank God for all of you listeners, man. Tune in again next week, man. Hey, look. I made a cover photo for tonight's for the new show. Man, I hope y'all like it, man, because I think I kind of dig it. I ain't trying to toot my own horn. I mean, you know, so many times, you know, you get folks to do stuff for you, and you ask them to do this, you ask them to do that, but when you find out how to do something, you know, I've been actually making flyers now for probably about two, 3 years, I guess. You know, but I had to get people to do this and that for me, do this and that for me. And I got a couple tips, and then I used them tips, and I got better and better and better. And now I'm pretty much decent in it now. But I thank God for allowing me to do those. We might need to get some different pictures though, cause I look kind of swollen up, my head shining. I was gonna say who I look like. Either the old Rock. I look like the Rock, or. Somebody done told me I look like Suge Knight. I said, no, I don't want to look like that Joker. I'm about to call him crazy. I don't want to look like that crazy Joker. Amen. I don't want to look like him. I want to look like me. But we gonna get some better pictures, and I'm gonna continue to make some nice pictures for this show, this new show. This new show is fire. And we just thank God for it. Amen. But look, let me tell you about the announcements, is what's happening in town. We got announcements for the local area, Lewisburg, Franklin County area. Free Salvation Holiness Church. We'll be having their women's conference December the 16th at 11 o'clock a.m. Their guest speaker will be Minister Brenda Sewell. And the church address is 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, 27549. Healing Word Ministries Women Conference 2018. The theme is Deliverance, March the 23rd and March the 24th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The location will be at a later date. So we're still working on, we got two locations. We're trying to get confirmation on either or. But we just want you to mark those dates down and the time. March the 23rd and March the 24th at 7 p.m. because you got the date and you got the time. And even if we had to have it outside, amen, at least you got the date and you got the time. You can already put that on your block time on your calendar. March the 23rd, March the 24th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Lewisburg, in the Lewisburg area. Healing Word Ministry Winter Revival, we are working on that. That's under construction. Deliverance 2018, the mission stands. Amen. February the 15th through the 17th, 7:30 p.m. nightly. And the location is to be announced at another time. I've already confirmed one speaker. Amen. So we're going to continue to work. We're getting working on the location as well. Amen. But the contact is on vacation. So that's why we haven't gotten that yet, because they still on vacation. Won't come back until the first of the year, and I don't have their cell phone. I just have the office number, so y'all bear with me. The Circle of Love Prayer Partners will be having their revival January the 22nd through the 26th, and we will be broadcasting every night the revival for the Circle of Love Prayer Partners. Amen. The first year I did that, 2 years ago, we had over 200 some people to listen to the broadcast that week. Amen. We're praying for double, amen, that amount. So y'all get on that phone, get on that social media, and you let them people know, look, join in to the TMA Radio broadcast January the 22nd through the 26th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Amen. We're going to have a different speaker every night. Amen. Sharing the word from the Lord. And also for those that don't have an internet, so you ain't left out either. Amen. Those that might be driving from work and you don't want to be on your phone, amen, you can dial up the Circle of Love Prayer Partners prayer line. And the number is 218-548-2848. And the pin code is 81056. That's 218-548-2848. And the pin code is 81056. Amen. The third Sunday hour of power is this Sunday. Y'all better get ready. Get ready. Get ready. We got a special guest, Prophetess Tina Talley, Senior Pastor of the Power of Rhema Church out of Durham. Amen. Our friends from up in Durham. Amen. She will be the guest for the third Sunday hour of power with the word. The third Sunday hour of power with the word is at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So it's this Sunday at 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And it's brought to you by the TMA Radio Broadcast and the Circle of Love Prayer Partners prayer line. It's amen. So I think that's it for all of the announcements. If you're listening to the third Sunday Hour Power with the Word and you have a grandfather, grandmother that don't know how to operate a cell phone or a tablet to get online, dial up the number to the Circle of Love Prayer Partners prayer line. 218-548-2848, and the pin code is 81056. You can listen to the third Sunday Hour Power on that conference line as well. Amen. As well as the revival. And I think that's it for the announcements. I'm trying to double check. Yep, that's it for the announcements. Amen. So listen, we got weather coming up for you in just a bit. We're going to continue this broadcast. This next song we're about to play, well, she's been on this broadcast. She's gave her testimony. She's out of New York, Long Island. Her name is Jenny Lee Mercer with her song that's on one of the albums she's working on, You Have Overcome, on the TMA Radio broadcast, and we'll be right back. me down. Jesus was overcome. I tell you, wonderful voice, wonderful song. We want to thank her for sharing just a few weeks ago her testimony, amen, on this broadcast. It was amazing. It was powerful. If you didn't listen to it, you knew, listen to this broadcast for the first time, check, think about 3 weeks ago on, it's on Midweek Praise. So look on the Midweek Praise and you'll find my dear sister Jenny Lee Mercer's testimony. It was awesome. Amen. Let's go to the weather forecast tonight. Partly cloudy, low of 30 degrees. And then on Thursday, mostly clear skies, high of 51 with a low of 30. And then Friday, mostly cloudy, high of 47 degrees with a low of 27. And that's your 2.5 forecast. Now, you got in the weather, you got in announcements, you've gotten the best of the best talk show on Wednesday night on Midweek Praise. Amen. Men to men talk back. Amen. That's what it is. The talker. Excuse me. We're going to be here every Wednesday night starting at 9 o'clock. Amen. So we thank God for that in this broadcast. Listen, continue to listen, share this broadcast on social media page and be blessed in the Lord. Also, if you want to become a sponsor of this radio ministry, you can email me at PastorAckridge2016@gmail.com. Again, that's Pastor Ackridge, that's AKRIDGE2016@gmail.com. Amen. Or if you're my page, on this broadcast page, you can also email the Minister Ackridge Show at gmail.com. Also, either one works perfect. Whatever the amount the Lord bless your heart to give, amen, do so. We're going to take this up higher. We haven't helped a lot of people from the show in a while as far as financial, because we used to get blessings in the show. That's how serious it was. When we first started, we had people that would give us, send us money, and we were able to help two families when we did this some years ago. And I haven't asked and I haven't petitioned for you guys to sow your seed or anything in a while. But as we kicking gears now, we're going to a new season. Amen. If you have a business, a product, a service, and we'll do your announcements for, we'll broadcast your announcements for a low fee. We'll get the people out here. If you're in the Franklin County area, Wake Forest area, Wendell area, Zebulon area, Henderson, Rocky Mount, Oxford, Franklinton, wherever you are, Youngsville, wherever you are, amen. we are talk about your business here on the show for a blessing of a low fee, amen. So again, we doing that. I love you with the love of the Lord, and we're gonna leave you with "I Need You Now." This is dedicated to all of you listening out here tonight. Make sure you keep your eyes open, but make sure you have your ears wide open, because you don't want to miss nothing with either one. You don't want to miss nothing from seeing, and you don't want to miss nothing from not hearing. And you want to be able to hear what somebody's saying, but y'all want to see stuff too. So you got to have both hand in hand. All right, God bless you. Again, we'll be here the same time next week, buddy. Next week, we're going to have some more fire. So let somebody know we here and we popping on the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America, the TMA Radio Broadcast. I've been your host, Pastor Ackers. We see you on tomorrow night between 8 and 9 p.m. for Thursday night. God bless.
Not a second or another minute. Not an hour of another day. But at this moment when my arms outstretched, I need you lay away. As you have done so many times before, through an open, open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right. I need you now, I need you now, I need you now,
Not an hour.